Hi friends, myself Sainath Lambade, and today we are going to discuss about the adrenal gland. The another name for the adrenal gland, suprarenal gland. Supra means actually this gland is present at the superior part of the kidneys. So location, first of all we'll see the location of this adrenal gland. A pair of adrenal glands, superior pole or the upper border of each kidney. Actually they are present at the superior pole or upper border of the pole. Origin, mesodermal and ectodermal in origin, also known as a dual origin gland. As a adrenal gland is also known as a dual origin. It shows the origin from the two germ layer, that is a mesoderm as well as the ectoderm. First of all, I will show you the one diagram of one kidney. Actually, this is one kidney, and this adrenal gland actually is present on the superior pole of the kidney. This is the outer region of this adrenal gland, that is called as a cortex region. And this is a medulla part, that is called as a medulla. Actually, this gland has been divided into main two regions. So we are having the pair of kidneys and pair of adrenal gland. So again, one more I will draw for you. That is present on the superior part. So it is also called as suprarenal. This is a cortex. And this is called as a medulla. So adrenal gland are small, looking like a cone shape, conical yellowish gland, and shows a two distinct region. Actually this outer region of this gland is called as a cortex region, and this middle or inner region, that is known as a medulla. So this adrenal gland divide into two distinct region, that is outer region is known as a cortex region and inner region is known as a medulla region. This adrenal cortex is derived from the embryonic mesoderm. Actually this cortex is derived from the only mesoderm, and this adrenal cortex secretes many hormones together called as a corticoids. This adrenal cortex secretes the hormone. Which hormone do they secrete? They secrete the hormones known as the corticoids. They are commonly known as, together known as a corticoids hormone, which acts on the several activity of the human body. We'll discuss. Adrenal cortex is again divided into three parts. Actually, this cortex region has been divided into three parts. Outer is a zona glomerulosa. Middle is a zona fasciculata. And inner is a zona reticularis. So this adrenal cortex again divided into three parts. I have given A, B and C. Outer is zona glomerulosa, middle zona fasciculata, and inner is the zona reticularis. First, one by one we'll see that zona glomerulosa. It secretes the mineralocorticoids. This zona glomerulosa, the outermost layer of the adrenal cortex, it do the secretion of mineralocorticoids and they release for regulating sodium and potassium ions. As you know that sodium and potassium ions plays a very vital role in our body, so ion concentration. They regulate the salt and water balance. They also regulate the salt water balance, blood volume and blood pressure. After this aldosterone, actually this is a corticoid hormone, that is aldosterone, that salt retaining hormone. It is also known as a salt retain. Retain means to keep the salt, that is retaining in the body. So it will keep the salt in the storage form. Retaining salt, retaining hormone, main mineralocorticoid, also is the main mineralocorticoid, means it do the balance of minerals. It balances sodium and potassium level. middle is zona fasciculata. Middle one is a zona fasciculata. It is responsible for secreting of glucocorticoids. This middle zona fasciculata that responsible for secreting the hormone that is the glucocorticoids like a cortisol. That is also known as cortisols. It regulates the metabolism of carbohydrates, proteins and lipids. Cortisol stimulate the gluconeogenesis, lipolysis and proteolysis. Breakdown, that is formation of glucose, lipids and proteins. Breakdown, then it is also responsible for increasing the blood glucose level. This glucocorticoids that is responsible for the increase in the blood glucose level, it is also immunosuppressor. Means it also suppresses our immunity power. It suppresses synthesis of antibodies. It suppresses where the antibodies is going to generate, that antibodies are suppressed by this glucocorticoids. So it is also used in the treatment of allergy. They are also utilizing the treatment of allergy. It prepares the animal to face the emergency. It prepares the animal to face the emergency in nature. Then inner one, the thin zona reticularis, it is also responsible for the production of sex corticoids, or it is also known as a gonadocorticoids. In males, they have a role in the development and maintenance of external sex characters. In the male, it shows the development of external sex characters. Excess of sex corticoids in the female causes adrenal virilism or hirsutism. Means virilism means having the excess hair on a face. Actually, excess secretion of androgen in the female body that shows virilism and hirsutism. That endocrine and metabolic disorder, you may say, or low voice. As in the puberty in the male, there is a low pitch voice. That hirsutism causes a low pitch voice in the female. While in the male, it causes a gynecomastia. Example means enlargement of the breast in the male. Androgen and estradiols are produced by the adrenal cortex. This androgen and estradiols are produced by the adrenal cortex. Then after this, we'll see the disorders related to the adrenal cortex. The hyposecretion means low secretion. Hypo means low secretion of mineralocorticoids and glucocorticoids is responsible for the Addison's disease. This characteristic feature of this Addison's are the low blood pressure, a low sodium and high potassium concentration in the blood plasma, increases loss of sodium and water in the urine. It leads to the weight loss, weakness, nausea, means feeling like vomiting and diarrhea. These are some of the symptoms shown by the hyposecretion of the mineralocorticoids. This hypersecretion means high secretion of the glucocorticoids produce Cushing disease. It leads to the high blood pressure. It leads to the high blood pressure level, excretion of glucose in the urine. Means excretion of glucose in the urine, a rise in the sodium in blood volume and high blood pressure. Has a rise in the sodium that will increase the blood volume, high blood pressure and obesity and wasting of limb muscles. Means wasting means there is a decrease in the muscle mass due to the lack of physical activity. This adrenal medulla, now this is the middle part of this adrenal gland, adrenal medulla, it develops from the ectoderm. It secretes the two hormones, that is adrenaline. Adrenaline is also known as epinephrine, or noradrenaline is known as norepinephrine, and adrenal is also known as a emergency hormone, also called as a 3F hormone. 3F means at the time of fight, at the time of flight, when we are in taking off, then fright, when we are in a danger zone, or and noradrenaline regulates the blood pressure under the normal condition, and it also acts as a vasoconstriction, means it do the concentration or contraction of the blood vessel. So thank you.